In this video, I will show you how to integrate secant cubex dx. So by looking at this integral here, it's not easy to just integrate like this. But how should we start? Now for the usual thing, we probably would try to break that out into secant x times secant square x dx. So what do you see here? Now you pretty much have like a product of two functions. If you try to integrate a product of two functions, you probably would think about using the integration by parts. Now think about this. We can easily integrate secant square x dx because it's tangent of x, but we can also easily differentiate secant square x. So we can easily differentiate one function and you can easily integrate one function. You can actually use the integration by part. So let's try that. So recall the integration by part formula. Integral of u dv is equal to uv minus integral of v du. So what do we set u is equal to? Well, we will let u equal to secant x. Then we can easily differentiate this. Du is equal to secant x tangent of x dx, because the derivative of secant x is secant squared. The derivative of secant x is secant x tangent of x. Then of course dv is equal to secant square x dx. Then what is v? V is the integral of this, which is tangent of x. Now we have all the elements, we can actually apply the integration by part technique. So integral of secant cube x dx is the same as, okay, u times v. So basically secant x times tangent of x minus integral of v. V is tangent of x, so we have to write tangent of x times du secant x tangent x dx. Secant x, let's correct the writing, tangent of x dx. Okay, this part here is all good. We just have to deal with this part, the integral. But we know that, okay, tangent of x times tangent of x is tangent square x. We can just write it. Integral of secant cube x dx is equal to secant x tangent of x minus integral of secant x times tangent square x dx. Now, you just have to work with this. But what do you think of right now? Maybe you are thinking about using u substitution, but would that work? Well, what we have here is tangent square x secant x, not tangent x secant square x. And if we break it out, even if we leave it like this, right, the derivative of secant x is secant x tangent x, but the derivative of tangent of x is secant square x. So we cannot really do this. Well, the best thing what you can really think about right now is applying the trigonometry identity. What trigonometry identity do you have? Now think about this. We have 1 plus tangent square x is equal to secant square x. Then let's isolate tangent square x. Well, that would be secant square x minus 1. Now we have this, and we have, and that's equal to tangent square x, which is this. At least we can put that into here. Then we have everything the same. But look at this. We have secant square x and secant x. When we put this together, we have secant cube x dx. But the good thing is that this is a minus sign. So we can actually move it to this side and add it. So let's do it like that. This is integral of secant cube x dx. Let's go to secant x tangent of x minus integral of secant x times secant square x minus 1 dx. So I will replace tangent square x with secant square x minus 1 like this here. Then we can distribute the secant x here. Integral of secant cube x dx is equal to secant x tangent of x minus, I do put a bracket here because this is going to be two term, secant cube x dx. I distributed dx right now. Minus now integral of secant x dx. I will take out the bracket, and this will become a plus. So this is integral of secant cube x dx is equal to secant x tangent x minus integral of secant cube x dx. Let me write the integral sign better. Integral secant cube x dx, and this minus minus become plus. Integral of secant x dx. And of course, like this is minus. So if we add integral of secant cube x dx to both sides, we can move this one to this side. We're trying to group the like term together. So let's move this term to this side. So we will have integral of secant cube x dx plus integral of secant cube x dx is equal to on the right side, only these two terms left. So I will have secant x tangent x plus integral of secant x dx. Then this 2 would just become 2 times integral of secant cube x dx is equal to secant x tangent of x plus integral of secant x dx. Now, what we have to look into is just this one, integral of secant x dx. How do you do that? Well, let's talk about it from here. So integral of secant x dx, how should we do this? Now remember, secant x and tangent x, they go out the best. So you can try to think about writing something in terms of tangent of x as well. But you only have one secant x, right? We don't have like more than one. So what should we do? Well, we do know one thing, that the derivative of secant x is secant x tangent of x. Let me write this. Derivative of secant x is secant x tangent of x. And the derivative of tangent of x is secant square x. So given this information, we can actually do this. Integral of secant x times, we have secant x plus tangent of x over secant x plus tangent of x dx. Now realize that this fraction that I multiply is just 1. So 1 times the secant square x. No, I mean 1 times secant x dx is still secant x dx. I have not changed the integral at all. So what is that equal to? So this will be secant square x plus secant x tangent of x all over secant x plus tangent of x dx. What do we do? Now you know that tangent of x, the derivative of tangent of x is secant square x, and the derivative of secant x is secant x tangent of x. Then of course we can use a u substitution now. We'll let u equal to the bottom denominator. So u is equal to secant x plus tangent of x. Then du is equal to the derivative of secant x is secant x tangent x plus derivative of tangent of x is secant square x. Right, this thing times dx. So this basically is just the top, right? We can just multiply dx with this term. So this term is just du on the top, and the bottom is u. So we can rewrite this integral as 1 over u times du. So what will be the integral of this? ln of u. Of course, right, we have to rewrite u. We said u is secant x plus tangent of x, so we have to write this back. Ln natural log of secant x plus tangent of x. Tangent of x. Okay, so this is the integral of secant x. Yeah. So we know the integral of secant x here is ln natural log of secant x plus tangent x. So we can actually write this 2 times integral of secant cube x dx is equal to secant x tangent x plus ln of secant x plus tangent of x, because this is the integral of secant x dx. Of course, we are looking for integral of secant cube x dx, so we have to divide both sides by 2 to isolate that. So we have integral of secant cube x dx is equal to 1 half secant x tangent x plus 1 half ln of secant x plus tangent of x. Are we done? Yes, we are done. So we can complete this by adding the constant c at the back. So this is the integral for secant cube x dx. Hope you enjoyed this video. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Thank you.